The Bible has not been taught in the earth properly except by the Israelites. If you're not coming under the banner of Israel, you will not teach the Bible correctly. You will hide things. You will ignore scripture. You will reject scripture. Revelation 2 verse 13.
Revelation 2 verse 13. I know thy works and where thou dwellest, even where Satan's seat is. And thou holdest fast my name, and hast not denied my faith, even in those days wherein Antipas was my faithful martyr, who was slain among you where Satan dwelleth.
Now, it says where Satan's seat is. Now, this was in Pergamos. Rome had a foothold over there in Pergamos, where they had large chapels and all that of worship. They had a citadel set up to control the people. You might ask yourself, self, what does this have to do with us today? Now, this is a drawing of Washington, D.C. Now, these are the streets. When you follow the streets, look at the corners along Pennsylvania Avenue. I wrote it down, but I can't see too well.
5 points.
You got the 5 points. You got Washington Circle, bottom left. The top left, you got the DuPont Circle. The top right, you got the Logan Circle. The bottom right, you got Vernon Square. And in the center is Scott Circle, and it forms the goat head. Now, the Masons are the ones that designed this, the streets, not by accident.
That's right.
It was by design. So you might ask yourself, we read the scripture says, I know where thou dwellest, even where Satan's seat is. The capital of America, Washington, D.C., Delaware of District of Columbia. Thank you. I'm getting old, brothers. Bear with me. Is designed as the goat head, the pentagram, not by accident, but by design. Give me the next clip. That's an actual Google shot. Okay, give me a next one. Okay, on your dollar bill. Zoom in on that. The Masons. See the Anuit Coeptus? Novus Ordo Seclorum? You got those 5 points the goat heads too, from the A to the S in Coeptus. Okay? Novus Ordo Seclorum. New World Order. The all-seeing eye of Ra at the top.
Success,
yeah, Anuit Coeptus is a Latin for our enterprise, a success. These were done by Masons. Give me the next one. This is the actual shot where you got the White House. You can see the end of the goat head there from the White House. And Negroes were not allowed into Masons and Masonry for a long time. The ones they let in now is a pathetic, synthetic group of Masons.
Right.
They were not, during this time period, what was black people?
Slavery. Building the White House.
Right, we was building crap.
Supreme Court building and a U.S. Capitol. Right. Built all of that.
Getting our backs whipped to build this thing. Clip me another one. Right, here's another one. Now over there, they show you other streets where you got the six-pointed star for many of our brothers that think that symbol was righteous. Then you got the Masonic, what's it called? The compass sign with the Jesus.
Contractor,
thank you.
Right.
Okay, showing you the designs of the streets. Okay, everything in the District of Columbia, Washington, D.C. is by design. It's all witchcraft, thank you. That's the word I wanted, witchcraft. The Masonics, the Grand Lodges, the Master Masons, all supreme witches.
The Rothschilds, the DuPont.
And those are names, when they have meetings, Negroes are not allowed in those meetings. The super rich families. What's that? They say Jay-Z just became, he sits down with, who's that dude he had lunch with?
Buffett.
Huh?
Warren Buffett.
As rich as Jay-Z is, they're saying, oh, he's a Mason. He's a low-level, synthetic witch.
Right.
He's not allowed in those top meetings. That's, again, for you blacks, under the delusion of inclusion. You always think you're included in something. You're excluded. After the Emancipation Proclamation, They allow blacks to go into many of their churches and many of their Freemason lodges, but they had to do it on their own. Blacks started setting up their own lodges. Blacks started to try to set up their own churches. But it was all they mimicked was what they heard the white man echo. They were parakeets, just like today. You get our people up in, like they say, when you go before certain court systems, if there's a flag with the fringes, that's a military court, and a Mason got to stand a certain way. Something like that. So that the judge will be like, this is my brother. I'll be lenient on him. Listen, that's BS. That's BS. With all that secret society bullcrap. What we're bringing out of this Bible, don't nobody know but the Israelites. And when white people hear it, they're shocked and astounded. How y'all hear it? How y'all find out about that? We spent trillions to keep that secret. Why don't you ask these Masons with all their secret lodges, what is the true nationality of the Negro? You know all these deep sayings, these deep secrets. What is our nationality? You gonna come African? No, we ain't Africans. They always come back, I don't know. On my job, I got a whole lot of them. When they speak, I just want to vomit. I say, okay, with all your great supreme knowledge, with your secret, what have you done to help our people? It's so secret that they're dumb and simple. They can't figure out our nationality. They don't know nothing the Bible's talking about. It make you want to put your finger down your throat and puke. From there, Isaiah 47.
Yeah, the reason why blacks formulated these different groups, black groups, was during that time, after the Emancipation Proclamation, you had the Jim Crow.
That's right.
We were separate.
There you go.
Even after the Emancipation Proclamation, you had the Jim Crow laws, where it was separate but unequal.
Exactly.
Not equal, it changed it to unequal.
Unequal.
People get their own business.
I'm glad he brought that's heavy. Go ahead, I don't want to interrupt. Go ahead.
So, during that time, you had the Emancipation Proclamation, then you had the Jim Crow laws. We had to do our own water fountains, our own supermarkets, our own businesses, okay? And that's when Negroes started doing their own thing, copying Massa.
Right.
If he can do it, we can do it. Mm-hmm. We're going to do it like him. Not better than him, like him.
Exactly. I hope y'all understand that. Yes, that's right.
Yeah, also, back in the time when the Klansmen was in effect, a lot of them were Masons, and when they came upon blacks, and they tried to give them a Masonic sign, and they were still being put to death.
That was in Rosewood.
Hey. Hey, anybody? Hey, boy.
Yes, sir.
You traveling, man?
Who asking, sir?
Our problem.
He a Mason. Took the oath same as us.
He's a white Mason.
You think he'd help you?
I'm telling you, boy, I swear, sometime you ain't got more sense than some of these horses.
I'm telling you.
That man, he ain't nothing but trouble.
Well, let me tell you something. See, I ain't no boy. See, I's a man. I's a Mason. You be Sam.
They killed that dude. They beat him bloody. With the damn ring and everything. They beat the hell out of that dude. He died. Everybody else who wasn't a Mason.
Bro, brothers, we gotta come out of all. When the Bible says come out from among her and be separate, we gotta come out of all these little funky, strange religions that we adopted from Master.
Yeah.
We gotta come out of it, because it's gonna get us killed. Yes.
In the nation's capital in Washington, D.C., is some of the poorest ghettos in the whole country surrounding the entire capital.
Exactly. What's the irony behind that? Okay. Isaiah 47. No, I want to get to the point. Five. Let's start.
That thing you just said, brother. Say it again, Elder Nathaniel. What is what you said?
I don't know. What else?
No, what you just said.
What is
the irony behind that?
What is the irony behind that?
Because their slave who built never went nowhere.
Hey, Isaiah 47.
Verse 3?
No, let's start at verse 5.
Okay. Verse 5. Isaiah 47 verse 5.
Now, Isaiah is prophesying about Babylon the Great. Not ancient Babylon under Nebuchadnezzar. Isaiah is prophesying about the new Babylon, which is the United States of America. Okay? Let's start at verse 1. Let's just start at 1.
Yeah. Verse 1. Isaiah 47, verse 1. Come down and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon. Sit on the ground. There is no throne, O daughter of the Chaldeans, for thou shalt no more be called tender and delicate.
Because Babylon is called a tender and delicate nation, meaning a princely, a rich nation. That's what the term tender and delicate refers to. Okay?
Take the millstones and grind meal.
Meaning work.
Uncover thy locks.
Uncover thy locks.
Make bare the leg.
Make bare the leg.
Uncover the thigh.
Uncover the thigh.
Pass over the rivers.
Pass over the rivers.
Thy nakedness shall be uncovered. Yea, thy shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance, and I will not meet thee as a man.
Now, let's stop right there. I'm going to show you an example. I want y'all to look at this verse. Notice in verse 1, it calls them, O virgin daughter of Babylon. When a woman is a virgin, technically she's never what? She has never been what? Technically, Zakai.
Yeah, she's never been touched.
She's never been touched. Now, look at verse 2. Watch. Now, Babylon, which is America, is portraying herself like a virgin, a tender and delicate woman, a rich woman. But look at verse 2 again.
Take the millstones and grind meal. Uncover thy locks.
Stop. Mm-hmm. The first thing, a righteous woman, a virgin woman in the scriptures always has her hair what?
Covered.
Her head is covered. Mm-hmm. So the first thing God says is uncover your locks. Take that head covering off. He's giving you a visual. Come on.
Make bare the leg.
Make bare the leg, because a righteous woman, her dress is where? It's down where?
Below the knees.
A little more. It's down to the ankle. This is going to show you how long it was. Read that part again.
Make bare the leg.
Make bare the leg. Go ahead.
Uncover the thigh.
See, the Bible makes a distinction between the leg and the thigh. Two different things. The leg is that calf area. Uncover it. Then he says, uncover the thigh. Pull that dress all the way up. Go ahead.
Pass over the rivers.
Pass over the rivers. I want you to walk. Because you know when a woman's walking over the water, she got to lift up her skirt. Yeah. So God is showing us something about Babylon. Go ahead.
He shows that women wore dresses also.
Exactly.
They wear no pants.
Right. Go ahead.
Verse 3. Thy nakedness shall be uncovered. Yea, thy shame shall be seen.
Why does it say thy shame? Yes, Abigail.
Because this woman is not a virgin.
She's not a virgin. Because as a virgin, when you can look at a woman, if you see her naked, and know she's a virgin. But a hoe, you look at her down there, you know she a hoe. Her thing is open, the wind is blowing, there's an echo. Hello, hello, hello. So God is saying, I'm going to show everybody that this country is not a virgin. She's not a delicate woman. She's a a wicked and vile woman who's portraying herself righteous and virgin. No, but she's not. Come on.
Couldn't expect that. Verse 3. Thy nakedness shall be uncovered. Yea, thy shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance.
So God is going to take vengeance on this country. Come on.
And I will not meet thee as a man.
So the Christ you remember during the time of Rome that allowed himself, I'm going to say it again, that allowed himself to be put on the cross and nailed to it. He said, I'm not going to meet you like that no more. When I come back, what did he say?
I will not meet thee as a man.
He's going to come as God. Because only a God can take down this country. Mm-hmm. Yep. Just like in ancient Egypt. Only God could take down ancient Egypt. Egypt was the most powerful country on earth. So likewise today, for all you
Italians,
non-believers out there, or you, anybody out there, I'm going to just say this, in case online or watching this clip, if anybody got any terrorist thought in your dumb, stupid mind, you are not taking down this country. It's too powerful. They got satellites that can wipe your behind out instantly. You got a 9mm, you got an AK. Brother, you ain't got nothing. Even in Philly, remember in Philadelphia, about when year was that?
Not Wall Street.
When was that?
That's the movement you're talking about.
Yes.
The bombs on the 1985.
Thank you. You good, brother. 1985. They dropped a bomb on the movement. That was a group of blacks who got together and said, we could get weapons together. Mm-hmm. The mayor said, and the mayor was black too, so they couldn't come with no racist thing.
Wow.
Mr. President, what should I do? Drop a bomb on them. Boom! Killed women! Killed everybody was dead.
He moved them.
Yeah, he moved them. That's in case, because you got how people get simple. I'm going to get some weapons and I'm going to do. You ain't doing nothing. You ain't doing nothing.
All you got to do is turn the wall off.
Exactly. Yeah,
you know what amazing? You know what Mosiah let us know? This kingdom here is the most powerful kingdom. Most High have to take it down. That's how Mosiah let you know that Esau is the most powerful man. He have to be the one who take it down. No man can take it down but God, Jesus the Christ. You understand?
The Mosiah wanted it that way.
That's right.
He wanted to be the one to take him out so that everybody would be afraid of him.
Let's get that. Romans 9.
Yeah.
Here's the proof for you black. That's what. This ain't no black revolution.
Zealous.
This is a Bible revolution. This is an Israelite revolution, because we're going to gather the 12 tribes. They're going to be gathered together in these last days. And guess what? And when that 144,000 is sealed, when the last one is sealed, the Bible says, and then shall the end come. Romans 9.
For the scripture saith unto Pharaoh, even for the same purpose have I raised thee up.
So just as God raised up ancient Egypt, Africans, to be the top nation on earth. Go ahead.
That I might show my power in thee.
See that? That God might show his power in thee. Go ahead.
And that my name might be declared throughout all the earth.
Because when Egypt was destroyed, everybody knew it was the one true God. The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob. That God is the God that destroyed them Africans in Egypt.
Sorry.
Go ahead.
Verse 22. What if God, willing to show his wrath and to make his power known, endured with much long suffering the vessels of wrath fitted to destruction?
So God, willing to show his wrath and to make his power known, endured with much long suffering. Because a lot of us ask, oh Lord, we've been here hundreds of years. When are you coming to deliver us, Lord? That's why it's saying endured with much long suffering. The vessels of wrath fitted. What does that word fitted mean?
Designed.
Designed. Created to be fitted to destruction. Created to destruction. So you want to know why this country got so much power, so much technology, and they're going further and further, so much further than any nation on earth has ever gone. Mosiah said, don't worry, I got this.
Nation's trying to keep up.
Exactly.
Let me get the next one.
Come on.
Isaiah 42, verse 13 and 14.
Watch, I want everybody to get it. Isaiah 42, verse 13 and 14.
The Lord shall go forth as a mighty man. You remember he said earlier he's going to meet him as a man. Lord? Right. The Lord shall go forth.
And here we're
at. Isaiah chapter 42, verse 13 and verse 14. The Lord shall go forth as a mighty man. He shall stir up jealousy like a man of war. He shall cry, yea, roar. He shall prevail against his enemy.
You see that? That's a powerful precept. He shall prevail against, what's the word he used right there?
His enemies.
Friend, oh, for you black people that think the white man is your friend, you think America's your friend. Friends don't put friends in slavery. Mm-hmm. Friends don't take your mothers and fathers and separate your families. Friends don't change your nationality and raise you up as a nigger. Nigger. I'm sorry, internet. I know y'all not used to that word. But I gotta shock some of you blacks that's all in the, I'm just so loving.
That's because they've been assimilated.
Right.
Verse 14. Now this is coming out of Romans 9:22, where the Lord said that he endured with much long suffering. We're going to read about that. This is verse 14 in Isaiah 42. I have long time holding my peace. That's the long suffering. I have been still and refrained myself. Now will I cry like a travailing woman. I will destroy and devour at once.
Explain it. I'm just reading.
So the Lord is saying that, like when we read over there in Romans, where he said that he has endured with much long suffering. At this point here, he's going to be free from that prophecy, because the Lord can't break his word. He says, so when that time comes where he can let it loose, that's why it says, now will I cry. Meaning he's free to tear behind up. Now will I cry like a travailing woman. I will destroy and devour at once. That's when it's going to be, well, that's when the angel is going to say, it is finished.
Can we read on? Read on.
Okay. I will make waste mountains and hills.
And when God says he will make waste mountains and hills, he ain't talking about literal mountains and hills. He talking about governments. Great governments are the mountains. Little governments are the hills. Go ahead.
And dry up all their herbs. Mm-hmm. And I will make the rivers islands. And I will dry up the pools.
Everything on this side of the world is going to be ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Come on.
And I will bring the blind by the way that they knew not.
We're the blind. He said, I'm going to bring the blind because we're the ones that can't see properly. I'm going to bring them by the way they knew not. Go ahead.
I will lead them in paths that they have not known.
What? See, everything we know right now, the little bit that we know, that's why the Bible says, eye has not seen, ear has not heard what God has in store for those that love him. Love him. Come on.
I will make darkness light before them.
God says regarding the Israelites, I will make darkness like light before them. So you got these brothers and sisters in these lodges. I see things. No, you don't see nothing.
But the devil.
But the devil. You don't see nothing, Mr. 33rd degree. Or whatever. What is it? 32 or 33? You don't see nothing. Or Mr. Grandmaster, yes. What we see in this Bible, the little bit that the Most High has opened our eyes to, is greater than all the wisdom on the world. In the world. Now, the next level, when we're delivered, what did God say?
I will make darkness light before them, and crooked things straight. These things will I do unto them, and not forsake them.
So God says he will not forsake us. He's going to make darkness as light before us. Things that appear crooked shall be made straight. Just when we're on the scene, when the Israelites are on the scene, that's some power right there. We have not known the likes of that since Moses, since Christ. Okay, let's go back to Isaiah 47.
I have polluted mine inheritance and given them into thine hand. Thou didn't show them no mercy. Upon the ancient hast thou very heavily laid thy yoke.
Mm-hmm. They didn't care if they were old. They put the yoke on them, right?
And thou saidest, I shall be a lady forever.
So this kingdom says they should be a queen, a lady of kingdoms forever. Go ahead.
So that thou didst not lay these things to thy heart.
They didn't lay these things that they did to us to heart. That's why you got blacks talking about where's our 40 acres and America ain't giving you no 40 acres and nothing. They ain't care about nothing about us. Go ahead.
Neither didst remember the latter end of it.
Right, they didn't remember the latter end. Because the latter end, Israel's going to wake up. Christ gonna return. Bad.
Therefore, hear now this, thou that art given to pleasure.
This is a country given to pleasures. Mm-hmm. Whatever feels good, do it. Go ahead.
That dwellest carelessly.
This country dwelleth carelessly. Go ahead.
That sayest in thine heart, I am.
So this country says I am. That's why America does what they want. In the United Nations, when they try to have those little meetings, at the end of the meeting, America doesn't abide by what the other nations say. America goes and does what she wants to do regardless. Come on.
That sayest in thine heart, I am, and none else beside me. I shall not sit as a widow, neither shall I know the loss of children.
So America says they're not going to have the loss of children. Their people ain't getting killed. That's why when there's wars, they put us on the front line. Put the white boys in the back. Put them blacks and Latinos in the front. That's what they do.
You know, that's heavy because the way it's being put out, it said, yes, put them out front, but we're not looking at us. We're not looking at ourselves as a separate entity from them.
Right.
We're saying, yes, because we're fighting for our country.
Uh-huh.
That's the mentality that we have, but yet they throw our behinds in the front.
Exactly. Come on.
But these two things shall come to be in a moment, in one day.
Watch what's going to come to Babylon the Great.
The loss of children.
The loss of children.
And widowhood.
And widowhood. All their allies going to be put to death, right?
They shall come upon thee in their perfection.
These nations, the terror, they shall come upon thee in their perfection. Go ahead.
For the multitude of thy sorcery.
What?
For the multitude of thy sorcery.
Let's get that picture again. Give me that photo again of Washington. This country was founded on Masonic witchcraft. Understand that. On the bottom, give me that dollar bill on the bottom of that pyramid in Roman numerals. 1776. This had nothing to do with Negroes. We were in slavery, brothers. These Masonic witches set all this stuff up, which was for our demise, our destruction. Not for our prosperity, not for our blessings, but for our death and destruction, to always be slaves. Okay? Read that. Well, let's go back to what God says again, so we understand. The Bible is the only true book on earth.
But these two things shall come to be in a moment, in one day. The loss of children and widowhood.
Because war is going to come to this country here. We ain't really see that little World Trade thing. That was nothing. You ain't see nothing yet to what God's talking about. Come on.
They shall come upon thee in their perfection.
That's what we read at the beginning of the lesson in Habakkuk chapter 2 about the nations. Come on.
For the multitude of thy sorceries.
For the multitude of thy sorceries. A lot of you don't realize that television, it's sorcery. It manipulates the minds of the people. It gets you into that Christmas spirit. TV gets you into that Thanksgiving mentality. Now look at this thing right here. On an eagle, e pluribus unum. E pluribus is Latin for out of many, unum is one. Out of many, one. Out of many, one. Because when all the European countries came to this continent and it was fighting, then they decided to forge themselves as one nation. That's what it's talking about. Out of many, one. I didn't get to that yet. Out of many, one. The arrows and the left talon of the eagle represented the Native American Indians, the tribe of Gad. They came with war and the peace olive branch. America said, oh, we come with peace. But they slaughtered Gad and put him on reservations. Now go up. The six-pointed, see those stars right there? Them pentagrams? That form, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 stars form a hexagram, the six-pointed star.
The devil.
Right, which represents the land of Israel. Showing you that the land of Israel is an extension of America. That's why America gives Israel over $7 billion. Was it 70?
Seven.
What is it?
It used to be 10. Years ago.
So now it's $70 billion dollars in aid. But when they give us money, they call it welfare. But they don't call it welfare when they give it to Israel. In God we trust. They put a movie out, not that, the Bible. Yeah. They said the God that America's referring to, that God is an acronym for gold, oil, and drugs.
Right.
Yeah. That's the acronym for the God they're making reference. That's what every war is based on. Gold, oil, and drugs. Don't fall for that democracy crap. About, oh, we need to help the people of Syria. Oh, look at how, what kind of trauma, I forgot the president of Syria's name, what he's doing. Oh, America's the police of the nations? No. There's something in it for this country. Yes.
You remember when America took over Iraq, that the Iraqis were complaining that they were being forced to grow opium now?
That's right, exactly.
They were happy because the government went down, but that they could grow regular crops.
Mm-hmm.
They were protesting because they were being forced to grow opium.
That's right. That's right. And all these nations that got oil, that's what we read earlier at the beginning of the lesson about that embargo, that sanction they put on Iran regarding their oil. Imports and export. That's gold, oil, and drugs. That's the God of this country. In God we trust.
They got this from Columbus.
They got, it's already reported, documented that. They got the military growing opium in Afghanistan.
Mm. Check that out.
Afghanistan is the largest producer of opium. And America's trying to get their hands on the opium over there because China relies on Afghanistan for the opium because it's 90% Buddhist over there. They smoke opium. So America's trying to gain access over there so they have leverage over China because America's debt is mostly helped by China. That's America. America's very cunning and in an evil place. So when you try to uphold this place, you simple as hell.
You had a Negro pastor who had five boys accuse him of sodomizing them at a young age. Y'all know him, Pastor Eddie Long. Okay, it looked like the man was on his way to jail. Now all the boys are silent, and they're praising this man now as a king.
You may have a seat. I want to demonstrate something to you. Praise God. How many feel an anointing in the room? Amen. This is God's government. This is a scroll that's 312 years old. I have dual citizenship in Israel on behalf of the Jewish people, the land of Israel, and the God of Israel. I want to make a presentation. Praise God. Amen. Bishop, you will come. Bishop, you will come. Praise God. Praise God. He is a king. God's blessed him. He's a humble man. But in him is kingship. In him is royalty. In him was the land of Israel. In him was a K chromosome of that of Cohen Kohanim. He was brought through the slaves, raised up in a city. And God now wants to release a new anointing. We're in a different season, ladies and gentlemen. If you'll come, Bishop. Thank you so much, sir. Bishop, you'll turn and face this. He now looks as one who was once a slave, and his ancestors were once slaves. He's the first man in 3,500 years of his bloodline to return back to the original, seeing the original scroll, seeing the original letters. Ladies and gentlemen, if you turn, Bishop, towards me, and we're going to now surround him. This is done in the kings of Israel. They surround him, raise it in the air. He had now wrap him in the scroll room, real slow, real slow, real slow. He's wrapped in the Word of God. He's sealed by the blood of the Messiah. He is sealed to come out with a new anointing. The kingship within him, the power within him is going to come out. It doesn't matter where you go. Now, how you try to attack him, you can't attack him. He's sealed wherever he works, wherever he turns, the power of God is there. As we open this up, every ambassador, every king, this is done to every king. We open up and he's hidden in the Word of God. He is hidden in the Word of God. Amen. Now, Bishop, you'll have a seat. Praise God. He's now positioned in a position of power and authority. He has given within him a belt. On one side is justice, and the other is blessing. He now is given the Constitution of God as a king. I give this to you, Bishop, as a sign of covenant, as a sign of release, as my sign of love for you. Amen. My brothers will come forth, four sons, representing the four corners of the earth. They'll raise him up right now. He now is raised up from a commoner to a kingship. Come on, raise it up. And I'll walk him around. Come on! Come on, praise God. Turn to face here. Turn to face me. Hold it in the air. He's no longer a commoner. He's not on the earth. He's raised from earth into a heavenly realm. He's raised in a prophetic position. He's released by God. He's breaking pagan traditions, breaking areas of God. He's releasing Atlanta, Georgia. It's not him. It's the king in him. Say this with me. Stretch forth your hand. Stretch forth your hand. Say, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift you up and give you a special anointing. And from the Prince of Peace, Yeshua HaMashiach, we love you, Bishop. We raise you up. We raise you up for such a time as this. God has made a prophet out of you, and we release the anointing in Yeshua's name. Amen. Let's sing the song. Sing the song.
And then they began to pray number six. The Lord hear thee, bless thee, and keep thee. The Lord make his face to shine upon thee.
That was a mockery.
That was a mockery. As they uplifted him, and right, that's it right there. They wrapped them in scriptures. And then they prayed, Numbers chapter 6. The holy prayer that God told Moses to pray over our people.
Y'all need to listen up to what the elder say, because he's making a heavy point.
That's the holy burrito.
Okay, so that was some supreme wickedness right there.
That's right.
Okay, you have many blacks right back there clapping and applauding. Thousands upon thousands. Clapping and applauding for him to be the king over our people.
Brother, when you see things like that, really what they're telling us, we got a serious job to do. These are sick people, man. Another man. Those are sick, sick of our people. The elder, they're telling us, welcome to America. That's what America is about. You can commit child molester, you the king. That's what America is about. Homosexual, lesbian. But this is the country that our people giving in to.
If he was speaking, if Elor was speaking to a righteous congregation, guess what would have happened to that place? It would have shut down. Because people would have been coming with scriptures. He would have to explain himself. But he's speaking to a bunch of dumb, uneducated, when it comes to the Bible, Negroes.
Yep.
They have no education in the law. So they can't condemn them. They can't condemn them.
Yes, yeah, because many of them are guilty of the same...
Exactly.
Same.
Exactly.
Let's go back to Isaiah 47.
And verse 10.
Hmm? Isaiah 47, verse 10.
So this is a result of what the Most High says shall happen to Babylon the Great, the United States of America. And why?
Isaiah 47, verse 10. For thou hast trusted in thy wickedness.
America has trusted in her wickedness. She's done much evil throughout the planet. And she has trusted in it. Go ahead.
Thou hast said, none seeth me.
None seeth me. Who's going to speak up against me? Anybody that stood up and spoke against America, what happened to them? That person got put to death. Ask Noriega, jacked up, thrown in jail like Noriega. Okay, come on.
Thy wisdom and thy knowledge, it hath perverted thee.
So that's what we said earlier. All the technology that this country has, nobody can match the technological advances of America. The Bible says your wisdom has perverted thee. That's why they say I am and none beside me. Who can rival America? Nobody on earth. Come on.
And thou hast said in thine heart, I am.
I am, meaning I'm God.
And none else beside me.
Come on.
Therefore shall evil come upon thee.
So God is prophesying evil against this place. Get nervous. It's fine. But wait for it. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it shall surely come. Go ahead.
Therefore shall evil come upon thee, thou shalt not know from whence it riseth.
With all the technology that America has, they can listen to your conversation with your cell phone. Mm-hmm. Y'all saw that movie Batman, the last one.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Remember the scene where Batman, at the end, he created something where he could hear everything through the phone. You know what I'm talking about?
Morgan Freeman.
That wasn't make-believe. Whatever technology you see in the movies, America already has it. They're waiting for opportunity to bring it out.
The name for it today is called Bluetooth.
Bluetooth?
That's right. Because to link a Bluetooth device, like your earpiece, you need a serial number. Okay? You can use it, you can link it to your car, like I have one for my car. I punch in a code and I can pick it up. But guess what? There's times when I'm trying to link my phone to the Bluetooth of my radio, and it's picking up all the other cars that are around me and all the other phones that are around me. So I'm telling you, the only thing that's stopping that from happening is punching in a couple of numbers. They already got a way around that.
Yeah, exactly.
They already have a way around it.
Come on.
Therefore shall evil come upon thee, thou shalt not know from whence it riseth.
So why are we teaching that evil shall come upon this place? Because God teaches us that. We ain't making this up. This is not rhetoric. This is not personal feelings, because personal feelings dictates we love this place. This is the greatest place on earth. That's what a person's emotion says. But we ain't going by our emotions. We going by thus saith the Lord. This is what the Bible says. Read it again.
Therefore shall evil come upon thee. Thou shalt not know from whence it riseth. And mischief shall fall upon thee.
Didn't we read that in Habakkuk? About the terrible of the nations shall come upon this place. They shall awake that shall vex thee. They shall rise up that shall bite thee. Habakkuk is saying the same thing Isaiah is saying. Okay?
Thou shalt not be able to put it off.
The Bible says with all their military, law enforcement, technology, it says they will not be able to put it off. That's why. What was that Arab dude in the military that caught attitude?
Caught attitude, shot up a whole bunch of people and sent in his base.
Right, on his base.
Did you have some?
Right. You're going to see a lot of things like, no, that's on a low level.
Fort Hood.
You're going to see, what the Bible's talking about is on a major scale. Major. We see little things now, pow, pow, pow. That's little. What God is saying going to happen, it's going to be so major, it's going to shock everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
And desolation shall come upon thee suddenly, which thou shalt not know.
Y'all see that? Desolation means total destruction shall come upon thee, which thou shalt not know. Come on.
Stand now with thy enchantments.
Ronald Reagan was big into enchantments.
Mm-hmm.
Going to his astronomers, his stargazers and all that.
Prognosticators.
He was heavy into him and his wife.
Mm-hmm.
Many of the presidents are into that thing. Read it again.
Stand now with thine enchantments and with the multitude of thy sorcery.
They had Billy Graham and many of these top ministers counseling them.
Witches
on what to do with the state of Israel. What to do with the Palestinians. What to do with the Arabs.
Stand now with thine enchantments and with the multitude of thy sorcery, wherein thou hast labored from thy youth.
Ooh, 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 ooh. Mm-hmm. Wait a minute. Read that part again.
Wherein thou hast labored from thy youth.
Read that part, the whole verse again.
Stand now with thine enchantments, and with the multitude of thy sorceries, wherein thou hast labored from thy youth.
Their youth was around 1776.
Yeah.
All these things that we're showing you on the screen, with the layout of the District of Columbia, these things like here, their street layouts, read it again, I thought, so we can see what God is warning us about.
Stand now with thine enchantments and with the multitude of thy sorceries, wherein thou hast labored from thy youth.
Since America was young,
mm-hmm.
she labored in her sorceries, her enchantments from when they was a young country.
Washington, right. Jefferson, Lincoln, all of those witches.
Right. Exactly. All those presidents.
Founding fathers, so-called.
All those founding fathers belong to Masonic Lodge.
Right.
Masonic Lodge is where they do demonic rituals, where they strip butt naked and lay in graves and do mock burials.
Like skull and bones.
Skull and bones, right. All of those people from their youth, before there was in America. Okay? The founding fathers and all of them was dealing with Masonic lodges.
Yep.
If so be thou shalt be able to profit, if so be thou mayest prevail.
So God is mocking this place.
Right.
Use your witchcraft. Save yourself from what I'm about to bring upon you. Yes.
Yes, indeed.
Those are those skull and bones. That's the Bohemian grove.
The owl god Moloch, they worship.
Right. They worship Satan.
Mm-hmm.
That's them laying in the grave right there.
That's the mock.
Moloch is the owl god.
And this is the level of Masonic rituals that Negroes are not allowed in.
Mm-hmm.
They don't want, because they know black people got big mouths. And they know our spirit is not in conjunction with their spirit. The witchcraft won't work properly if we're in the midst of it.
That's right.
Because give me that scripture in Numbers about witchcraft.
They'll only bring his simple butt in there to sacrifice him to the demons. That's the only reason why they bring him in there. They say, yeah, you're part of us. They say, you know, they tie his behind up like a hog. Because if you notice now, they're showing a lot of celebrities. They're showing you a lot of celebrities now that they're linking them to these demonic organizations.
Kanye.
They're only using these artists because they know these dumb Negroes look up to them. So they can use these dumb Negroes to manipulate the dumb congregation of blacks that look up to them and idolize them. It's not because they say we like black folk now. But these black folk think they made it, and they're just being used.
You know an example of that? Kanye's video, Power. Did y'all see that video?
Yeah,
they said that was the most Masonic witchcraft video ever. It had so much symbolism in it to draw our people away from the one true God into witchcraft.
And paranoia.
Right, and paranoia. Yeah. Exactly. Right, that's it right there.
Paranoia, that's right there. Those eyes glow.
Look at this. Foolishness.
Okay?
Oh, but you gotta have a soul that sacrifices it.
They, in the video, they had lesbianism, homosexuality, all kind of evil was in this clip.
And the spin on it is that he's being creative. He's taking the music to another level.
They're saying he's supposed to be posing as Dionysus.
Right. He got the Egyptian head of Ra on his around his neck.
His neck, yeah.
You see that Egyptian god on his neck?
Yeah.
And that sword, I forgot what the name of that sword is, with the ring around.
Hey, and the woman with the horns coming out of her head.
Right, go down, Bezalel.
Is an albino model.
Right.
Wow. I got pictures of her on the internet.
He's an
albino. You see her on both sides. She's an albino.
And the one sitting down is supposed to represent a level in the Masons of called cherub, seraphim. See, she got four wings on her. All that is witchcraft. All of that is witchcraft.
That's not Hollywood being creative. Everything was well thought out.
Exactly.
Everything. When you open down to the last detail.
And their CD, their album, the CD is a cross, a golden cross, and they got four praying demons in the bottom of it on their CD. God is called Kanye.
And the music is pumping. The music will draw you in.
Yeah.
Because they're chanting.
Right.
That, it's a chat.
All that is witchcraft.
But a dumb, unlearned Negro don't understand nothing. What y'all do, you bob your heads to it.
Right.
And play it for your kids. That's why we don't care what black people think. Get mad. Die, nigga, die.
The only thing that... Give me that Numbers 24 where they tried to curse us. This is why the white man don't let blacks up into their upper echelon in their witchcraft rituals.
Numbers 23, verse 23. Surely there is no enchantment against Jacob, neither is there any divination against Israel. According to this time, it shall be said of Jacob and of Israel, what have God wrought?
What have God wrought? So witchcraft don't work on our people. That's why, and that's when you come into the knowledge of this truth. This Bible is our protection.
That's right.
That's why when they have those secret meetings, they do not let our people in there. Because they know on the left-hand side that enchantment will not work the way they plan it to work. So they exclude us from these things. And we're so ignorant and don't realize, why, Massa? Why can't I be in your little witchcraft ritual? He's not gonna say because you're an Israelite. Enchantments don't work around you. Read it again so this can sink. For all you people on the internet, some of you Haitians or West Indians, somebody put the Dr. Buzzard done laid some on me.
Surely there is no enchantment against Jacob. Neither is there any divination against Israel.
Read it again.
Surely there is no enchantment against Jacob. Neither is there any divination against Israel. According to this time, it shall be said of Jacob and of Israel, what if God wrought?
What if God wrought? Because we are not like any other nation on the planet.
That's right.
We are a peculiar people. That's what the Bible calls us, a peculiar people. You know why they worship the owl?
Right.
An owl can do what in darkness?
Yeah.
They can see. So they think that they can see through all this madness that they have established. They're saying that they can see clear. But what did we read in the Bible? God says regarding us, darkness shall be as light before us. So like Bezalel was showing, they established the owl.
That's
the White House. Molech. That's the guy, that's Molech, the owl god. And his symbol is six-pointed star. That's his symbol.
Right, the symbol of Molech, like,
it's right here in the middle. It's two, Molech has two symbols. He has a five-point star, that's the weakest symbol, and the 6 points, the stronger symbol.
See, that's the owl right here.
Yeah, owl right there in the middle. Yep.
The hexagram.
At the tip, at the of the damn triangle. Look at that. Damn.
Right. Y'all see that?
Wow. Right there.
Yes,
part. The owl's on a dollar bill. Yeah, the owl's on a dollar bill also.
Exactly.
He's real small.
Right. There's looking at the too.
They're scholars. They're saying that they're the elite.
They pulled the dollar. They pulled the dollar. So I pulled it, the owl. Right there.
That's kind
of. Yeah. That was.
So,
right here is what you want.
Those, like we were saying, the so-called founding fathers of this country, all these things was done without Negroes. We were never included in this stuff. And thank God for that. Thank the Most High for that.
Well, the Negro, he want to join it. He ain't getting in there.
To show you how well thought out this evil is. Y'all remember when the Twin Towers went down and you could fold the 20 to show the building burning?
Right.
That's not by accident, bro. That's not by accident.
Those are printed 10 years,
okay,
years before.
Okay, how much in advance were those buildings?
They were printed like years before.
Okay, so they saw the destruction through their witchcraft.
Mm-hmm. In detail.
In detail.
The $5
and designed
bill.
A $20 bill.
And the 5 and 10.
And the 5 and 10.
Mm-hmm. Check that out.
There's another witchcraft.
Oh yeah.
That's the Washington statue.
George Washington, yeah.
And he's doing the same pose as Baphomet.
Now I want y'all to see the goat head, the Baphomet. The symbol between, see the point, Bezalel, go to the top of that burning thing.
Right.
One.
The six-pointed star is the Baphomet symbol. So when you got Israelites that sport that symbol, that's the satanic symbol. Okay, and that's why it's not found in the Holy Bible.
Who just had a baby that they're glorifying? Everybody's dying to see the baby. Okay, she's in the newspaper today. They have video of that same demon on her clothing and in her videos.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to tell me that's an accident.
Isaiah 47 verse 12. Stand now with thine enchantments and with the multitude of thy sorceries, wherein thou hast labored from thy youth.
So this whole society God is revealing is based upon sorcery. Right?
If so be thou shalt be able to profit, if so be thou mayest prevail.
Come on.
Thou art wearied in the multitude of thy counsels.
Thou art wearied in the multitude of thy counsels, their meetings.
See?
Their secret society meetings. Go ahead.
Let now the astrologers, the stargazers, the monthly prognosticators stand up and save thee from these things that shall come upon thee.
Y'all see that? So God is mocking Babylon. Let all your witches come forth and save you from what I've prepared for you. Go ahead.
Behold, they shall be as stubble.
God says they shall be burnt up. Go ahead.
The fire shall burn them.
That's that nuclear fire that's going to come to this place. That's mentioned in Isaiah 34. That's mentioned in Revelation 18. That's mentioned in Peter chapter 3. Go ahead.
They shall not deliver themselves from the power of the flame.
Y'all see that?
There shall not be a coal to warm at.
No comfort to warm yourself.
Nor fire to sit before it.
No comfort. That's what he's saying.
Thus shall they be unto thee with whom thou hast labored, even thy merchants from thy youth.
Didn't we read about the merchants in Revelation 18?
Yep.
It's talking about the same thing. Go ahead.
Even thy merchants from thy youth, they shall wander everyone to his quarter, None shall save them.
All merchants shall return to their own lands. Mm-hmm. That's Bible prophecy, brothers and sisters. Bible prophecy. So you in the right place. You learning the right and proper understanding. We would do you a disservice if we didn't show you everything. Many times we want to deal with the mysteries and all that. I only deal with that once in a while. Because knowing all this ain't going to help you if you're in the midst of adultery. Mm-hmm. Knowing all this ain't going to help you if you're a thief. Knowing all this ain't going to help you if you're a down low homo. Knowing all this ain't going to help you if you're a pedophile.
Yep. Or if you hate your brother.
Knowing all this ain't going to help you if you hate your brother. Knowing all this won't help you if you're a rapist. That's why the majority of our classes we deal with the deep basics. How to apply the laws to our lives. But once in a while, you're going to catch us and we're going to bring out topics like what we brought out today so that you understand what time period you're living in.